Good afternoon. It's a big day for TV5's smart investor. The smartest of all investors, inventor, venture capitalist, the father of Pentium chip, Mr. Vinod Dam, he is in our studios right now. It's a great moment for us. He is a mentor and advisor on the boards of many companies. So, chinna brief profile chadutanu. In 1993, Vinod Dam was named one of the top 25 executives in the US computer industry. In 1999, he was named one of the top 100 most influential Asian Americans of the decade. In 2000, he was appointed to serve on the President's Advisory Commission on Asian Americans by President Bill Clinton. Amar Bose, Indra Nooyi, Vinod Khosla, Lakshmi Mittal, Arun Sarin, Vanti, Hema Hemila Sarasana, 2007lo, Pravasa Bharatiya Divaslo, Bharat Prabhutvam, Vinod Dam Satkarinchindi, chinna brief profile matrame idi. He's a great man. So, pleasure to have you here in our studios, Mr. Vinod Dam. Vinod Dam garu patu, manto studios lo unnaru, India Partners, India Venture Capital Firm. So, India Partners promoters, Satish Andhra garu, alage Ramesh Bairapaneni. So, welcome to TV5 Studios, sir.
Thank you.
Me lunch appointments anitni pakkan vetti maa kosam vachinanduku. We are happy to see you here. So, I'll begin with you, Vinod. With a quote of yours, of course. The best thing that happened to me was joining Intel, and the best thing that happened to me was leaving Intel. Why did you say that? Had you continued with Intel, you would have invented many Pentiums or great innovations?
Not really. If I stayed with Intel, I had already become a vice president. Once you reach that level in a corporate management, then your job beyond that, you can grow and keep on getting more salaries and titles, mm-hmm. but your role is no longer technical, it's no longer innovation, it's no longer creativity and entrepreneurship, it's more of being a company man, a corporate citizen, and okay. doing whatever the company wants you to do.
So that entrepreneurial bug that bites you normally at some stage made you leave Intel?
Absolutely. In fact, that was probably the last year of my life I could have left and then discovered this underground world, okay. I call it, of startups, which is all very black box, or okay. used to be much blacker than it is now.
Okay. So that time, startup world itself was not there.
Yeah, the startup world was there, but it was only few people knew how to raise funding, what are series A, B, C rounds, how the valuations are done, what's the dilution, what are the various term sheets. Mm. All these terminologies, most of us didn't know. But okay. now, clearly, thanks yeah. to actually Indians, we have made it more public. All
it's,
of it.
It's more evolved now than that time. And you're 65 now?
I'm 66, going to be 67 this year.
Going to be 67. So very soon, a septuagenarian Vinod Dam will see. So at a time when you're supposed to lead a relaxed life, like last night you were saying at India event, you joined hands with India. So what made you do this? At this juncture?
I think the job in India is still not done. When I came in here 10 years ago, I founded a fund, Indo-US Venture Partners. The intent was to establish a VC ecosystem, mm-hmm. which I'm really glad has happened to a large degree, and there are so many VC funds now. I didn't anticipate it will take off as well as it has taken off.
Okay.
But what has happened in the last 10 years is what I call VC 1.0, mm-hmm. which is just awareness about what venture capital is, what startups are, and leveraging whatever India offered, which is mostly consumer-based companies. Mm-hmm. Now is when the real game is going to start, okay. where we have much more mature entrepreneurs, much more mature VC ecosystem, and the kind of products, technologies, intellectual property on a global basis that India will deliver is what is going to be the next 10-year story. And India, although it's a small fund, is very much on the forefront of it, thanks to Satish and Dr. Ramesh. They've been doing some really groundbreaking work with tremendous commitment, passion, to carve out a new niche that most of the funds in India have not yet thought through.
Do you really think that the next decade, Indian startups will really develop intellectual property and be innovative? Innovation slowly will seepage into the Indian startup system?
Not only I think that will happen, it's actually already happening. I've been associated as a venture partner with this fund for last 6 months.
Okay.
And some of the deals were reviewed yesterday. There are already people who are doing work in that entails artificial intelligence, deep learning, neural networks, machine-to-machine learning, all the themes that will be required to be embedded in every software, in every industry, in every vertical in next 10 to 20 years to make them more perfect, more efficient, and more productive.
Okay, so I'll bring Satish at this juncture into the interview. So, Satish, last night to some, six of your investments, one of them, like Vinod said, they are into artificial intelligence, I think related to healthcare solutions, something related to healthcare solutions. I didn't clearly understand what really the company was, but they are really high-end technologies. So, six investments in Japan.
So, largely, you know, before I go into investments, Andy, I want to, of course, say a couple of things.
Yeah.
About two very bright people who are on my right and who is on my left. As an engineer, you know, I'm an electronics and communication engineer, then did computer engineering, right? So Vin is for us, you know, obviously someone who we looked up to,
okay.
You know, while
yes,
growing
yes.
up and going to college.
True.
While in Valley, you know, followed him and obviously has done very well for himself and for the country.
Did you ever think that Vin will join you as a partner?
So it was, you know, obviously he was our role model, right?
True.
He was a role model for all of us and had an opportunity to be on a board. We invested in one company together, but the most beautiful thing was how humble and how approachable is Vin.
True.
While Vin can disagree with you, will have his own viewpoint, but you know, he's one of the best persons, you know, to have that very candid conversation, and he's very approachable. So it's definitely a pleasure and an honor, you know, to work with Vin. And of course, my other partner, Dr. Ramesh, who's a very eminent cardiologist,
True.
You know, who's now obviously donned the venture capital hat.
Mm-hmm.
So our, you know, vision is really ఇప్పుడు నేను చూసారు గోపిచంద్ గారు కూడా ఐ థింక్ యూ లెఫ్ట్ బై ద టైమ్ గోపి గారు
ఉన్నారు
సో వాట్ యు నో గోపి గారు హెస్ డన్ ఇన్ బ్యాడ్మింటన్ రైట్ యు నో ఎ నేషన్ దట్ డిడ్ బిలీవ్ యు నో దట్ వీ కుడ్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ ఒలింపియన్స్ వీ కుడ్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ వరల్డ్ బీటర్స్ ఐ థింక్ ప్రోడక్ట్ హెస్ బీన్ ఇన్ ఆర్ డిఎన్ఏ యు నో ఇంటలెక్చువల్ ప్రాపర్టీ హెస్ బీన్ రన్నింగ్ త్రూ ఆర్ బ్లడ్ వైల్ ఐ థింక్ ఇట్స్ ఆల్ గ్రేట్ థింగ్ దట్ హెస్ హ్యాపెన్ మన ఐటీ సర్వీసెస్ అండ్ ఆల్ ఆర్ గోల్ వాస్ how do you mano entrepreneurs ni ela help cheyali so that they can go global and they can compete silicon valley companies gaani boston companies israeli companies to compete cheyadam ant easy kaadu it's a very difficult proposition
True.
Because of their technology ability and the amount of money availability in the market but we believe that the timing is right now for india that's how we have come together at india partners in terms of my investments andi already hansel and oka company undi వాళ్ళు ఏం చేస్తారంటే మొబైల్ అప్లికేషన్స్ క్రాష్ అవుతే మనం అందరం డౌన్లోడ్ చేస్తాం వాట్సాప్ ఆర్ ఫేస్బుక్ మెసెంజర్ ఆర్ ఈవెన్ ఊబర్ ఆర్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ దీస్ యాప్స్ ఇఫ్ దే క్రాష్ ద డెవలపర్స్ ఆఫ్ దోస్ అప్లికేషన్స్ డూ నాట్ నో వై దట్ అప్లికేషన్ హెస్ క్రాష్డ్ సో దిస్ పర్టికులర్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ అనలైజెస్ ద క్రాష్ అండ్ దెన్ హెల్ప్స్ ద డెవలపర్ టు ఫిక్స్ ద క్రాష్ సో దట్ ద యూజర్ ఈస్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ రమేష్ గారు చెప్తారు సిక్టుపల్ గురించి ది ఆర్టిఫిషియల్ ఇంటెలిజెన్స్ మెషిన్ లెర్నింగ్ అదే కంపెనీ ఇక్కడే మన హైదరాబాద్ వాళ్ళు డార్విన్ బాక్స్ వాళ్ళు దేర్ హెచ్ఆర్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ హ్యూమన్ రిసోర్సెస్ కంప్లీట్లీ హైర్ టు రిటైర్ అంటారు లైఫ్ సైకిల్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టైమ్ అండ్ ఎంప్లాయీ ఎంటర్స్ టు ద టైమ్ దే రిటైర్ దే మేనేజ్ దట్ ఎంటైర్ లైఫ్ సైకిల్ ఇట్స్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఆన్ ద క్లౌడ్ బట్ ఇట్స్ వెరీ ఈజీ టు యూస్ అన్లైక్ ఎన్ SAP ఆర్ Oracle విచ్ టేక్స్ సెవెరల్ మంత్స్ టు ఈవెన్ కస్టమైజ్ ఇట్స్ అవైలబుల్ ఆన్ మొబైల్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ రెలవెంట్ ఫార్ ఇండియా
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, vallandaru kuda, all these entrepreneurs, not just they went to IIT or IIMs or, you know, Harvards or Stanfords, but most importantly, they have the domain knowledge. They have the understanding of the customer. So we're very excited about this journey, which Vin calls as the VC 2.0 journey.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Ramesh sir, స్టెంట్ ప్రైసెస్ తగ్గక ముందే మీరు కార్డియాలజీ నుంచి ఆల్మోస్ట్ బయటకు వచ్చేసినట్లుగా అనిపిస్తుంది సో ఏంటి రీజన్ అసలు ఈ విసి అవతారంలోకి రావడానికి కారణం ఏంటి
ఐ థింక్ యాజ్ అ డాక్టర్ ఈవెన్ యువర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్డ్ 50 మంది పేషెంట్స్ చూస్తున్నారు అనుకోండి లైఫ్ లాంగ్ ప్రతిరోజు 50 మంది చూడగలుగుతారు యూ కెనాట్ సీ 5,000 పేషెంట్స్ ఎ డే
ట్రూ
And also, you can't think out of the box. For example, I'll give an example of this, a company called Sigtuple, where we invested. Young boys, all from computer science background, not from medical background. And all these years, doctors never thought about it, using computers for diagnostics.
Okay.
Peripheral blood lo, rakarakala blood cells untai. RBC ani, WBC ani.
True.
Within the WBC, neutrophils, lymphocytes, eosinophils, basophils. Prati cell ki oka particular characteristic untadi.
Okay.
Size, the shape, the color, the thickness, the granularity, nucleus unda leda. So we never thought a machine can read this.
ప్రస్తుతం ఇప్పుడు మాన్యువల్ గా టెలిస్కోప్ లో చూసి మైక్రోస్కోప్ లో చూసి కనుక్కుంటూ ఉంటారు.
Yes, డాక్టర్ హ్యాస్ టు పర్టికులర్ స్పెండ్ 10 minutes అండ్ రైట్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ న్యూట్రోఫిల్, దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ మోనోసైట్. మెషిన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ టు కౌంట్, బట్ మార్ఫలాజికల్ అబ్నార్మాలిటీస్ ఇస్ నో మెషిన్ టు డయాగ్నోస్ మార్ఫలాజికల్ అబ్నార్మాలిటీస్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ పారాసైట్ ఉంటుంది బ్లడ్ లో, మలేరియా కానీ, ఏఎఫ్బి, యాసిడ్ ఫాస్ట్ బాసిల్లై, అది కనీసం 20 minutes పడుతుంది a doctor to scan hundreds and hundreds of specimens. But that particular parasite has a characteristics. If a computer is taught how to identify that, it can scan these 200 spots and come up with a diagnosis. So it completely aids the or even cuts down the time needed by pathologists to re-verify.
So it automatically is a revolutionary step for a startup.
Yes, the blood day kaakunda, urine examination, semen examination, body fluids also, this company is trying to use the same technology. Alane retinal images, next step, or even chest x-rays. So I think the day has come, computers are becoming cheaper, the capacity, the computing power is so high, the computers can be taught what a particular cell looks like, particular disease looks like. In fact, meer vine untaru IBM Watson ani. In fact, a 10,000 square feet library lo unna books can be read in a few minutes by the computer. So for example, a complex cancer untadu ankonde, a particular patient.
So mana robo cinema lo chusam Rajinikanth robo ga oka inta pedda book ni kuda
takkon
scan chesi chadivesesi heroine ki help chestadu. Example,
absolutely, and this reality actually. So, and this computer has
no more fiction.
So many hundreds and hundreds of thousands of patients' data, which particular type of cancer, which particular type of cell, what receptors it has, and which combination of drugs will be effective in a particular patient, no human being can predict it. And it has proven that it can beat the best oncologist as far as predicting the diagnosis. I think it's the day now for computers, artificial intelligence, machine learning, neural networking to aid the doctors, and so it's better patient care finally.
Okay, so you know, over the last one decade, the startup scenario in India has changed significantly. You must have observed that from a consumer internet and e-commerce space to, like you said, leading to some innovative practices, innovative inventions. So do you think that in the next one decade we'll really become a country like Israel in terms of the startup ecosystem?
I think we should be a country 10 times the size of Israel in startup innovation, because if you look at their population is only 8 million people, we have 1.2 billion, but even if you look at just the talent, we have significantly large number of talent available. The issue is not that, the issue is how do we redirect that talent into in this area of product IP, global thinking, and as opposed to more service oriented.
True.
When we came 10 years ago, most people had come from IT industry, which is more service oriented, where they don't innovate and create things, but are told what to do. So we are shifting from what to do to saying, what should I do?
Okay. So what do you think the government should do to achieve this, sir?
You know, government can play a very significant role.
As in Israel level. Too, we have seen how the government has helped the startup ecosystem there. So so even here, the government's role is imminent, and they have to be proactive.
See, government's role is not to invest money in startups. That I will not be very happy about, because it's a very speculative game, as you know, because it depends on innovation. Innovation is a risky area, and no matter how much due diligence and preparedness you have, the statistics of the industry are that only 1 out of 10 startups gives you most of the return for your fund, and many of them fail, and some of them do just about okay. So government should not be in a business of actually investing money. However, government should take whatever capital they have and create a culture of innovation within the country. And to create the culture of innovation, which is what US has. Why is this US have so much innovation? If you go back and look at that, innovation has come from government funded projects for last 100 years. Even IBM became IBM because no company could buy a first IBM computer. Government bought it to do the census study.
Okay.
And a lot of work on semiconductor was for the NASA, because they were sending people on the moon, so they had to really create new devices to reduce the weight of the aircraft. So they funded that research into the Bell Labs. Internet came out of DARPA, which is also a defense operation research organization within the government. In fact, most of the fundamental work, innovation, VCs only take those innovations and actually commercialize and make money off of it.
Okay.
But the basic fundamental work has come from government, and government has funded that through universities, through the PhD and master's students doing work on these as a cheap labor. Because, you know, when you're a student, you get a few hundred dollars to work on a project, you're happy going doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And thousands of such projects, if only 5 or 10 of them become to fruition, that alone can change the face of industry.
Okay, so 2 years back, you have invested in an education startup here. I think that's name, AcadGuild. So how is it doing now?
AcadGuild is doing great.
Mm-hmm.
AcadGuild, again, was started based on a basic theme that, A, we need to provide job-ready skills. If you take computer science graduates in India, or even in America, they have learned a lot about computer science. But if you have to write program, they don't know how to write program, the latest program. Programs keep on changing too. So what we were providing was a complementary skill on top of. We were not replacing what they're doing. They still need to get their undergraduate degree and graduate degree. But we are going to give them more contemporary skills in how to program. For example, today, we're teaching machine learning, which is very, very contemporary, or data science, data analytics, artificial intelligence, neural networks. These are not being even taught in a more contemporary way in the colleges and universities. And so we have thousands of kids who have graduated. The key difference between AcadGuild and most of the other institutions called MOOCs,
mm-hmm,
is that we have 95% of our kids graduate, 97%. In others, 97% of them don't complete the coursework. And the reason is most of the others are based on watching video of a lecture, which is fine because you can start and stop and come back to. But we have actual people, mentors from industry, teaching that course live, where the students, 5 or 10 students, are on the other side who can ask questions, interact with each other, and we find that model to be far more effective way of learning.
Okay. So you must have observed of the latest developments in the startup scenario here, environment here. Snapdeal, you're one of the early investors, the first investors, I think. And we're seeing it facing a lot of problems. I think they're out of money now, is what is being reported in the media. And there are other cases like Stazilla. Some of them are shutting their shops down. So. What's going to happen? Is there a valuation bubble or something like that? Because valuation picture is now gradually coming down.
See, VC industry, like a human being and like a corporation, go through a learning cycle. We all learn in our life and go through ups and downs and then correct, self-correct and keep on growing. I think the general trend of venture capital in India is nothing but positive.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be a great growth. It's still a country which is highly talent and a lot of innovative spirit here. But the learning last 10 years was the first time India got exposed to it. Unlike US, where we've been doing venture capital for 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
And even there, after 30 years, we went through what's called dot-bomb or dot-com and dot-bomb.
Yeah.
So even with all that learning.
So we can't compare it with the dot-bomb?
No. There is absolutely nothing like that. You know, this is just a correcting phase where the entrepreneurs, young entrepreneurs have gotten in, they're learning and they are self-recognizing and cognizant of what went right, what went wrong, mm-hmm. and they're self-correcting themselves and they'll be on their way. Okay. I don't have any such qualms about it.
Okay, and you're seeing it in USA. Indians are afraid of the situation there. Is it overly felt panic or do you think that things will normalize over a period of time?
I definitely hope and believe things will normalize over a period of time, and there's really unfortunate incident. I think you're talking about one
the,
of the
getting
shot in Kansas
yeah,
City.
Yeah.
It's very unfortunate, and by no stretch of imagination, I think anybody should read into America or Americans at large as being people who do acts of that nature. It so happened that one individual has done it. I hope it just stays where it is. And as the Trump administration comes together and he finds all his cabinet in position, there'll be a lot of moderating influence and what is practical and what needs to be done. You already can see that in many spheres of it. So I'm very hopeful that this would not be something that will be a norm and people don't need to get too
concerned.
You're
also keenly watching tonight's Congress speech by Trump?
I know it will be there. Maybe I will be able to watch or not. I'm not sure about.
Okay.
I don't think there's anything about him that is we don't know. So
in fact, a lot of people in India feel that they treat Trump now as a villain of the picture. So how do you see it?
You know, he's our president, and he's there, and he's actually a smart businessman who's made himself successful. The concern people have is his positions that he's taken are quite extreme for a president. Now, a businessman can do what he wants in the business, but when you're president of a country, you have to be more thoughtful about how you bring about, even if you believe in a change, mm-hmm. it needs to be brought about with a lot of consultation, a lot of consensus building within your own portfolios, and then going out and working with other countries. What we are finding is there's a reversal of the process. First, he tweets what his policy is,
true.
And then the people get very scared about what that is.
Okay.
And then he has his admin people who report to him, go out and actually patch up and say, actually, it is mm-hmm. what we all feel more comfortable about.
Okay.
So I think it's a matter of him getting used to how the politics works. He's not a politician. And hopefully us getting used to a businessman running a country. And I hope it really stays more moderated and not too extreme.
In fact, it should be like that because a politician doesn't really know the evils and good things about the system, whereas a businessman exactly knows that. So let's hope that Trump will succeed as a president.
Absolutely.
Like he succeeded
we have
as a businessman.
To make sure he succeeds for success of my country where I'm citizen today
yeah.
and success of all of us because the globe depends on America
mm-hmm.
To a large extent, and it's very important that that country does well.
True. Thank you, Mr. Vinod. Thank you, Satish. Thank you, Ramesh.
Thank
in
you.
Fact,
thank you.
There's a lot to be discussed, but we have completely run out of time. So thanks for
thanks
coming
for
here.
Having us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, idi father of Pentium engineer Vinod Thamto, Pratyeka Chercha. Keep watching TV5. Thank you.